It was the furthest point of navigation and the culminating point of my experience. Man without madness can't stand in the sun. My passage on a seagoing steamer. The sun was face, and the land seemed to glisten and drip with steam. There was no joy in the brilliance of sunshine. Going up the river was like traveling back to the earliest beginnings of the world. We penetrated deeper and deeper into the heart of darkness. Kurtz might be dead. After attacked by natives, that was the dominant thought. I had been striving after something altogether without a substance, like a blinding sunlight. What was it? Was it my childish dream? I hoped that Kurtz's words could be the pulsating stream of light from the heart of an impenetrable darkness, and I wasn't robbed of a belief nor missed my destiny in life. After a long journey, I found Kurtz. His intended, his ivory, his station, everything belonged to him, but that was a trifle. The thing is that he belonged to the powers of darkness, claimed him for their own. The
tribe trusts him very much, don't they?
They adore him.
Why are you so reluctant to speak of him?
What do you expect? They never saw anything like him. It came to them with thunder and lightning, and it was terrible. Terrible! Let me give you an idea of what he is like. He wanted to shoot me one day.
Shoot you? What for?
I used to shoot game for some ivory from the chief. He declared that he would shoot me unless I handed it over, so I gave it to him. But I don't care. I can't leave him, although I have to be careful. He would go on ivory hunts, forgetting himself among all these people.
He's a madman.
Mr. Kurtz is not a madman. If you heard him speak, you would not suspect him of insanity.
Save me the ivory. You are interrupting my plans. I'll show you what can be done. I will return,
He's very low. We have done all we could have done for him, but it is too late to make up for his mistakes.
Nevertheless, I think he's a remarkable man.
He was. I can no longer conceal the knowledge of matters that would affect Mr. Kurtz's reputation.
Well, I am Mr. Kurtz's friend, in a way.
He suspects you of having an active ill will towards him.
Right. I remember a conversation I overheard. The manager thinks you ought to be hanged.
I better get out of the way quietly.
The ship breaks down. Cave this for me. This noxious fool is capable of prying into my boxes when I am not looking.
Kurtz gives Marlow his private papers since he believes the manager is treacherous. The next day, one evening, coming in with a candle, Marlow was startled to hear Kurtz say a little tremulously,
"I am lying here in the dark, waiting for death."
Oh, nonsense.
Marlow stood over Kurtz as if transfixed. At the same time, Marlow saw on that ivory face the expression of somber pride, of ruthless power, and hopeless despair.
The horror! The horror!
Mr. Kurtz is dead.
pilgrims rushed off to sea. Marlow was called brutally callous to Kurt's death. There was a beastly light where the remarkable man had once pronounced a judgment upon the adventures of his soul on this earth.
I remained to dream the nightmare out to the end, and to show my loyalty to Kurtz once more. Destiny, my destiny, droll thing life is, that mysterious arrangement of merciless logic for a futile purpose.
Marlow finally goes to meet the fiancé of Kurtz. The fiancé comes out the door dressed in mourning black. Even a year after the death of Kurtz, she was mourning his death.
You knew him well.
I knew him as well as it is possible for one man to know another.
And you admired him.
He was a remarkable man. It was impossible not to.
Love him. Who had heard him speak once? But you had heard him, you know.
Yes, I know.
What a loss to me, to us, to the world.
We shall always remember him. His words will remain.
I cannot believe that nobody will see him again. Never, never. He needed me, me. Forgive me, you were with him to the last.
To the very end. I heard his very last words.
Marlow hears the whisper, the horror, the horror all around.
His last word to live with. Don't you understand? I loved him, I loved him, I really loved him.
The last word he pronounced was your name.
I knew it, I was sure.
If I had rendered Kurtz that justice, which was his due? Hadn't he said he wanted only justice? But I couldn't. I could not tell her. It would have been too dark.
Certainly, we couldn't bear the sun anymore. Because there is darkness in every man's heart. Thank you.